Hours of coding can save you minutes of planning. You actually have to think about that for a sec.
Kids love technology. Most of the entertainment that they enjoy these days is based around technology, and inherently, at its core, is actually computer science, my subject area.
He has a great way with students.
He really does get you out there, and he shows you what the real world is like.
Pat is always trying to bring home, how can we make this fun, how can we make this interesting, and how can we make it real world?
You can teach programming in a million ways, but he chooses to focus it on life issues, world issues, global issues.
Now is your opportunity to start thinking, what do I want to do with this knowledge I have?
Some of the programming concepts are really abstract, and he'll use like real life situations like about Lady Gaga or something to explain how certain things work out.
You really talk to him more and you kind of get how he feels about things, and there's a lot more personality rather than just content.
Students are involved with technology from the time they get up in the morning to the time they go to bed. At Springbrook, because of our technology program, our students have an advantage, a competitive edge that maybe other students don't have when they're looking to the future and also the here and now.
We create things that kids are actually using. So we create mobile applications. We create video games that they can play on their Xbox, on their mobile phone, on their PC. And kids get an experience not just with the nitty-gritty of computer programming, but also the entire design process. And that's something that we really enjoy offering here at Springbrook.
And our first place winner for innovation in content.
My project was about using game programming with the Microsoft Zune, which is a portable media player, to attract women into technology, and more importantly, keep them in technology.
For some reason, technology hasn't done a good job of creating women-friendly environments. And we're not going to be able to compete with the rest of the world if we don't involve 50% of our population. So there aren't enough women in technology. That's just it.
He's basically getting the word out, and it's probably helping a lot of people. Just actually even decide on their careers and encourage more women to get into the field.
We're trying to work harder too because we're inspired by his like success, and it's a really good impact on our program.
We have a club here at Springbrook called Springbrook Women in Technology, or SWIT. We had a lot of girls in our beginning level programming classes, but a lot of the girls didn't continue on like many of the boys did.
When I first started the programming classes, there was seriously probably four girls in the corner of the classroom, and the rest of the classroom, which was like 30 people, were all guys. And that was really intimidating because the guys would always be, you know, making jokes that we wouldn't get or stuff. So to continue on, I don't think I would have continued if Amita wasn't there.
Cindy and I, we've known each other since fourth grade. So we've actually had a lot of like good times together. So we've been in the same class with Mr. Y for all 3 years.
We increased the number of girls entering the computer science pathway to begin with, from intro and on, but we retained double the number of girls we normally retain. And we've kept that trend year after year. And in fact, this particular year, we doubled the number of girls in AP computer science.
I really appreciate that he's trying to let girls know that it's not just guys, and girls can do it.
He likes to take us out to not only talk about what we're doing, but also to sort of learn how what we're doing in the classroom right now can become a career, how it can become our lives in the future.
Having the kids go to a forum like the USA Today Education Forum and be recognized, they start to see that what they're doing is very innovative, cutting edge, and other folks really want to know about it.
It always sort of fills me with a sense of pride of my work when I get to speak to these people, because you know it makes me feel like I'm making a difference right now.
Interrobang is a social network, social missions game.
You don't just sit down on the computer, have a character, shoot some stuff or whatever. No, you actually go out, do the missions that you do, and you get points for it.
basically take pictures, write report about it, to share ideas about what I'm doing.
Got it?
Yep, got it.
What effects did the civil rights movement have on your life?
I wrote down some questions. I've videotaped it. I took notes on the interviews, and I'm going to edit it together to make a video so I can post it as my mission.
Students here at Springbrook have really jumped onto it. In 1 month, we've gone from zero to third place all time in Interrobang. All of its programming and web design, and it's a game, and it's within a social context. It's wonderful. It's a great example of what students can do with technology and how they can involve other students as well.
It really does show you what's out there for the students. They're designing their own games, they're doing websites, they're doing internships. So I think that students are learning while earning and also exploring what's out there in the future for them. And the future is bright for the students at Springbrook.
Mr. Y inspired us to do many things like this. What we want is just a clean world and us working together.
I really want my students to see that they have a role in making this world a better place, and the stuff that they're doing immediately now, they can have an impact on people because of the stuff they're learning in school.
We're very lucky to have Pat as a person in our school system, because he does stuff all over the world and collaborating with tons of different teachers that when you just observe him in the classroom, you don't know how much of an impact he really has. And I'd say the world of education.
I feel like it's just the best situation in Montgomery County for a technology program to grow.